Hey everyone, it's been a while since I've done my last review, but I finally got some time, so I wanted to go back and do a review on my favorite install that I have done to date, and that is the Solos Hold V2. I picked this up late last year, and probably didn't start this install till around November. Finished it up in early January, and made a couple like little changes here and there, but it's just about finished. There's a couple of things I still probably would like to do to it that I'll go over during the course of the video, but for the most part, I mean, she's pretty much done. This was, like I said, my second install. It's a Crystal Focus version 8 that's in here. I was a little nervous tackling that, but luckily there are some great people out in the community. I just want to give a shout out to Scarecrow on the Rebel Armory. He helped talk me through quite a few details on the board itself, on how to work it, certain wiring diagrams, things like that, on how I should get things done as far as the crystal chamber goes. And he's, you know, how to add a little bit more flair to this using a bar graph and things like that I'll show and go over. But obviously when the Solos Hold V2 comes to you, for those who don't know, it comes in all aluminum. Nothing is painted or weathered or anything like that. So it's just a beautiful, clean piece when it comes to you, and it's basically up to you to weather this whole thing. That probably scared the crap out of me at first, because I had not done that yet. You know, my first install was a Graflex 2.1. You know, all I had to do was basically put the thing together, do the install, and that was it. So now that I had to add some weathering to it, it felt like there was a little bit more of a challenge involved. So what I ended up using were some Rustoleum satin black for the black coating, and then what I ended up doing after that, I used troopertrent stencils. I put it all on, cleaned it all up afterwards, and then I used a satin clear coat on it. Although the clear coat that I had used was a Rustoleum, and it was a satin clear coat, but unfortunately, I don't know if it was the humidity at the time of year that I had done it, but there was like this milky white residue that was all over it, and it basically got stuck into the paint, and it didn't look right to me, and I was a little disappointed with it. So I actually had to strip the whole thing back down to the bare aluminum again. I had to order another stencil set to come in, which luckily I got it before he ended up ending that run. And I had to do it all over again. So everything again actually worked out well. Because I'd already done the stenciling the first time around, I actually felt a lot more confident the second time around. And I thought I hit some pretty nice details on it the second time that I didn't get on the first round. And then the second time around, I ended up using a min-wax lacquer satin, clear satin, and this actually worked out great. Once I sprayed everything on, it sealed nicely. There was no residue afterwards. And the shine, the coating itself, the condition looks perfect. I'm pretty happy with that. So here's a little view. Now, one of the things that I still have not gotten around to yet is dulling down the Roman's clamp. This is a clamp that I received at the very beginning of January that helped actually to complete this build. It was the clamp itself is really, really nice, well done. A couple of machine markings on it, but you know, from what I was told, that's pretty much normal. And I tried buffing those out as best I could with some steel wool. But the one thing I haven't done is really take this shine off of it. It's probably still a little bit too shiny for a V2. That should be a little bit dirtier. You know, I may look into replacing it with a satin one. We'll see how that kind of works out. But you know, for the most part, I think it definitely serves its purpose at this point in time. As you can see, I did put the gaffer's tape, which for screen accuracy. Putting that in there, I thought that was a really nice little touch. And you can just see some of the details that I tried to get up into the neck itself and also by the emitter. This was obviously the most complicated install that I've had to do at this point in time, just with the crystal chamber that was the reveal that they had. Using 2 5mm LEDs, one green, one white. This is a green, green, white tri-cree that's in here. I didn't end up doing an RGB. I wanted to be as screen accurate as I possibly could. I know a lot of people were doing blue LEDs and going with the photon to get the brightest green possible, but I didn't feel that was completely necessary. Here is the emitter itself. The one thing I did not bring myself to do was dinging the emitter. I know a lot of people were doing that because that was revealed on a lot of the photos that were released. I think it's Celebration. And then even more recently, the interview with Mark Hamill where he was presented with the V2, there was actually some really nice HD shots of that. And I think more people were going back and actually putting some like residual copper along here near the vein itself. So I haven't gone back and done anything like that just yet. I'm actually thinking about probably just leaving this. Let's see what other. So some other additions that I have made to this is I did Wanga's V2 clamp, his V2 lever, I should say, excuse me. And then I also did his D-ring. The D-ring that comes with the Solo's hold seemed a little big when I got it, so I just did some more research and saw that Roy had a really nice one up on his Wanga site, so I ended up purchasing that and putting it on, and I thought it came out great. And then the lever itself just seemed, the stock Solo's hold lever that came with this seemed a little too bland. I really enjoyed what Roy did with his. It's slightly different, and just the shine also, again, something else that I could probably just dull this just a little bit to kind of match the rest of the saber. And then of course Slothfurnace's card is for the clamp in there. Let me just take a look, guys. We'll open this up so you can see what's on the inside. I love the weight of this once it's completed. It does feel fantastic. It has a really nice heft to it. You know, I've swung this around a little bit, and it really doesn't bother me too much. The clamp's not really digging into my hand too much. I just don't know if I'm putting it in a good spot, like where I like to hold it from. I like to pretty much hold it from just under that neck and then just under the clamp, so it really doesn't really get in the way too much. But overall, I've really enjoyed this. I love the Luke Return of the Jedi hilts. I've said that before when I did my hero review, and there's so many different versions out there right now. And out of the main three that are seen on screen between the hero, the V2, and the V3, I love the hero and the V2 quite a bit. So I'm just happy I have these in my collection. So as you can see, it's Goth 3D's master chassis. And let me just get this kill key turned.
You must feel the force around you.
And the other thing that I really I have to play with a little bit more are the crystal chamber settings. I have it matching so that when it does clash and all that, it does flash that white. But when I turn it on, it's still not completely, it wasn't staying on, it still blinks a little bit. So I kind of have to go in there and just fiddle with the crystal chamber settings on there. I do have the rice port on here, as well as obviously the internal recharge port. I've tried the rice a little bit. I'm definitely not an expert when it comes to it. To that just yet. I have to kind of read up on that a little bit more and play around with that. I've done a lot of my settings manual. I just felt that to me that was a little bit easier for right now until I get a better understanding of it. Again, it was my first crystal focus installation, so being a noob at that probably didn't help and can explain why it's still a little confusing doing that using the rice tool, but that's something that I want to try to change. Anyway, here is the bar graph. That's by, I believe it's thrgk on Rebel Armory. It's an 8-segment. It's just green. Again, I didn't do anything special. I didn't do any... I've seen a lot of people do different colors, going up, powering up and down. I didn't do anything like that. And I didn't put in a little side LED. I know some people were putting one in right around here. I didn't end up doing that. I didn't want to complicate the install too much. I thought what I was doing, I could handle well enough. But I am pretty happy with this so far. It has the 28 millimeter premium speaker that's in here. I did my own weathering on the chassis a little bit. As you can see, I did a nice copper, and then some silver. Okay. All right. So let's turn this on. And the one fun thing when I got the clamp, I was so excited that I finally got it. When I was going to put it on, I had to, shave down the inner tabs. But unfortunately, because I didn't read well enough ahead, I just went along and started shaving them down. I shaved them both down. And then afterwards realized that I'm not supposed to do that. I was only supposed to shave down, I believe it's just the first one, the one that's later on. The upper one I'm supposed to leave so that it kind of holds in to the hilt itself. So unfortunately, I did not do that, but I do have another clamp coming in anyway that I might try to replace this with and just kind of put that, do it the right way so that it stays where it's supposed to. It doesn't really shift or move that much, but if I do go to turn the pommel down here and come out, sometimes this will shift slightly, so I'm always making sure that the holes, as you can see here, are lining up and that it's not shifting too much either way. Okay, so with that, I have quite a few sound fonts on here. I have Mad Cow's Hero, I have One Sith's Mark VI, I also have Lord Blaco's ROTJ on here. I believe I also have The Last Encounter that's on here. I think Chris Rigby put that one together. There were a few others that I was thinking about purchasing and putting on here since there's so many sound banks, but I just haven't gotten around to doing that all. So with that, I'm not gonna go through all the sound fonts, but I will kind of just fire some of this off, and at least actually let me fire it off when the chassis is open. And you can just see, I just have it simple going back and forth here. And then with a flash on clash, and lock up. As you see, while it's on right now, this is still pulsing, and I want to make that steady when it's turned on. I'm going to get around to doing that. I have to go back and play with the settings for the crystal chamber LED. I'm going to let that go. Now, the one thing I found is that, I don't know if this was like this with most people, or maybe it was just how I ended up doing my build when I closed it up. It definitely seems like it's a little tight sometimes sliding this portion on and off, getting the pommel on. Most likely, that's probably how the cover goes over the Goth chassis, I think. My cram foo might not have been as strong on this chassis, and that's why I don't know if it was like a little too fat on the bottom. I tried doing some shaving, pushing it in together, rearranging some wires, and that has helped a little bit. So again, I think that's just more or less figuring out a better way to cram them all in there. Some of my wires are probably a little bit longer than they should have been, how I ended up wiring it up, but again, I'm still pretty happy with how that all turned out. The rocker that's inside of here that works to the chassis and how they designed this, which was fantastic. But that little black piece that comes with, I actually ended up having to order a second one because when I ended up doing it the first time around, I was shaving it down. I thought I had done just enough, but I think I had done a little bit too much of the shaving. So what I ended up doing is I had to actually pad it. And things. It worked for a little bit, but it wasn't always precise. So sometimes you'd be pushing it or hitting it down in certain spots, and it wasn't coming through right away, or it actually would be holding down instead of pressing, so it would cycle through sound fonts, or it would just turn on, and it wouldn't, you know, or and it wouldn't shut off. So I just said, forget it, let me order another one. And as soon as I did it the right way, and it's been perfect ever since. I really haven't had an issue with that. So let me take off the emitter cap. Now, the one thing I ended up doing, I had a Vader's Vault's 7/8 blade that when I had put it in and used the standard washer that comes with the Solo's Hold V2, when I put that in there, there was actually some wobble that was going around between the open emitter and the blade. I contacted Aaron about that and said that sometimes the blades themselves could be slightly off. So what I ended up doing, and he suggested, was to contact Obi-Shane again on the Rebel Armory, because he obviously makes he was part of the design for the saber itself, and he had blades specifically made for this. And so that's what I ended up doing. I ended up getting two of his blades, and what he ends up doing is he actually has his own adapter for this that is actually glued on. So no, I keep this in the saber itself when it's in its display phase, but when it's time to put the blade in, I just obviously just take it out and put it off to the side. And then basically this just slides down. And I love the fact that you do not need any type of a blade retention key for this, that it's just, it actually screws in tight with this here, and now, like, this has been perfect. This is great. Doesn't move one bit. His blades are fantastic. After I saw these come in and I saw how bright they were, I ended up ordering two more 7/8 blades from him without the adapter, so that I can use them in some of my other hilts. And so with that, let me turn the lights out and let me get this thing turned on so we can see how bright this is. A second to adjust, and his blades are pretty even throughout. I do really, really enjoy that. And obviously, with no holes in the pommel, everything is vented through the clamp. And you can see that crystal chamber kind of blinking away. I thought they went to a tremendous effort to get it as screen accurate as possible. I know the one thing that they said, even when they were putting this whole thing together, was that they were debating on doing the uneven rings or not, and what they should do about that. But to be honest with you, I mean, I know that they went with a standard space for each one. But I mean, if you're the diehard person who needs that screen accuracy, you know, that might be something that you're going to look at, and that might bother you. I thought it's just a fantastic FX hilt, very, very well made, and to me, that doesn't really bother me as much. If they would have had it, yeah, it would have been a great added bonus, but sometimes you can't get everything. So I actually thought what they did was a really great job with this, and this is definitely my favorite install that I have done so far. It was the most challenging, but it's on my favorite hilt, so I really, you know, put in as much effort as I possibly could to get this as film accurate as I possibly can. I still want to make a couple little changes here and there, but for the most part, I'm still pretty happy with this. for the rocker in here again, just to go back to that real quick. And you can pick and choose where you want the activation and the secondary auxiliary switch to go. I ended up, for this case, going with the primary down in here and auxiliary here. It kind of just actually just felt better just in this position here. To turn it on and restricting it again versus just holding here.
I want to learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father. I am a Jedi. Like my
Obi-Wan has taught you well.
After R2, I have R2 as the font changes it's going through. There is actually the little menu font that's on here. I was happy enough that Jordan Eugene was able to send over to me his version that he had made up, which was the cut scene from Return of the Jedi when Luke is actually working on the hero version of the hilt, and that electronic sound is kind of going off, all those little noises. I actually really liked that a lot, so I actually messaged him and he sent that over to me, so I did end up putting it on this. And the next time I do another Crystal Focus, I'm going to, again, do that for another hilt of mine. So, yeah, I mean, other than that, guys, I think this is great. There are definitely some challenges. Weathering this thing scared the crap out of me. But, after my trial and error, I think it ended up coming out pretty well. I love the grips. Look at that little grenade section in there. I love the detailing in here that I was able to end up doing. And even up by the emitter itself, underneath the emitter. And even the cap. Booster section, I tried to end up scoring that a little bit. So it definitely looks a little bit grittier, a little bit dirtier than the rest of the saber, and I like that a lot. Someone actually even suggested to kind of even like, you can even like dirty up the card itself, the activation card, and I thought that was interesting. I actually had not thought about doing that yet, but that's something that I might change when I get the chance. I put a couple like little dings down in here. I mean, I know the Screen Accurate one has a bunch of different dings from drops and so forth, but I haven't scratched this up too much just yet. But I mean, overall, I am pretty happy with the saber. I am looking forward to Solo Hold's next release. I've pre-ordered the Orphan Knight, the Ezra lightsaber from season 3. So I'm looking forward to getting that in. The other two installs that I have right now that I'm going to be working on once the chassis come out is the RPF's Shared Stunt. I'm really looking forward to putting this guy together. Again, size comparison to these two, I mean, pretty darn close. So I am looking forward to that. This looks like a great hilt to make. This was done by Spirit of Obi-Wan on the RPF. And the other one that I actually just received recently is the Roman Props MK1, the weathered version. I really like this clamp. That's more of a matte finish. It's not as shiny. That's something that I may end up ordering and switching out on my V2 to make that look just a little bit more in line with what I have. But those are a couple more installs that I'm looking to do. I also just got my vintage Graflex, which I'm going to be doing the master chassis from Goth off of that. And yeah, guys, I mean, other than that, if you have any questions about the install or any comments, you want to put them in the section down below. I'm going to list all the little adaptations and changes that I made also in the description. I'll put the sound fonts that I have on here, the ones that are listed from for any like any of the Return of the Jedi styled fonts. The Return of the Jedi Facebook Attic group is a great source of information. I highly recommend, if you're looking to do an install like this and you have questions, go there. Again, the Rebel Armory, or former Imperial Royal Armory, the Imperial Royal Arms, They were a great resource for me as well. Multiple people on there were a big help. Troopertrent stencils, I'm sorry that he's not going to be doing any more of a run, and I was happy that I was able to get them while he did, because they are fantastic. I don't think I could have gotten mine as well detailed as I did without those stencils that he had done. I've seen people out there that have done a great job on their hilts without the stencils. I mean, those guys have put in a lot of time and effort, because doing the stencils alone, I thought I put in a lot of time and effort, but some of those guys who didn't have access to that and got those hilts as detailed as they did, you know, kudos to you guys. You guys did a great job. But this was, you know, fun, but definitely challenging install for my second one that I have ever done. I've done, you know, quite a few since, and things obviously get easier the more that you do them. But, you know, first Crystal Focus install, I had a bunch of people, you know, telling me to maybe not do that, to do a couple other ones first before I tackled it. But I just kept seeing this hilt bare, and I'm like, I got to get this thing going. I really wanted attempts to do it. And, you know, I think I picked it up pretty quickly, I think. You know, a couple little things for trial and error that I was able to figure out and work out on my own. But, you know, I'm happy with the way that it came out. And, it, you know, it definitely sets up on my shelf nicely, along with its hero. And then eventually the next that I have going on, so I can put a nice little collection together. But thank you again to those hold. You guys put out a great product. I'm looking forward to the next one. And yeah, guys, we'll probably hopefully be back soon with another install. So again, any questions or anything, guys, just write them down below. All right. Thanks a lot, guys. Take care.